DynamicSketch is the next plugin from Astute Graphics to receive a minor update in the annual service plan. This is one of the most frequently requested updates that we receive, so it's great to be able to present it. With sketching in Illustrator, as you can see in this example, there is a certain style where the paths are repeating a certain stroke profile. In this case, it looks like a variable stroke width. It isn't like the brush which you see in the background with these clouds, which is a more artistic and rougher effect. This is just a repeat of simple stroke widths. Now, with Dynamic Sketch, you can use a Wacom tablet, or in this case, I'm using an XP pen, which is a similar sort of device, to define stroke widths when you're sketching. And let me show that. If I go to the Window menu, Dynamic Sketch, Dynamic Sketch Panel, I can click on the Dynamic Sketch panel to activate the tool, and you can see it in the toolbox here, it's activated. And I could, because I've got this XP pen plugged in, I could go for stylus pressure. And when I draw with stylus pressure, I get a lovely preview, and the heavier I press on the tablet, the thicker the line, and equally the lighter I press, the thinner the line. And this gives a wonderful fluid result. I really like that. But sometimes that sort of input can get in the way. Here's an example. If I go quite jaggedy on my sketch, it's hard to maintain a uniformity that I'm seeking. So ideally what I want in a case like this is to actually predefine what width profile I want along the whole path. And I'm basically going to be ignoring the stylus input pressure or the sketching speed, whichever input type you want on here. So I'm going to go for none on the pull-down menu in the Dynamic Sketch panel, and I'm going to draw a simple single line. And to do that, I'm going to click and hold down, hold the Option key down, and drag out, holding the Shift key to make it horizontal, a line like this. Now, interestingly, you can instantly see it has retained the width profile I had when I drew that zigzag shape. Let me change that in the variable stroke width pull-down menu here, and I'll go for a more classic tapered effect, which starts very thin, goes to the thickest point, and ends up thin again. So you've already had a little glimpse of what it does. Basically, if I start drawing again now, you can see the preview is also showing me it's starting off thin, this stroke, and it's finishing thin with a thicker section in the middle. And doesn't matter how I'm pressing down on this XP Pen stylus here. So I'm maintaining this uniformity. If I do a shorter stroke like that, you can see it again. So it is really retaining what we see up here has been defined as the variable stroke width. You can even see here's an offset stroke width, and because I've got all the paths still selected, you can see how that has changed the profile of those paths, and it'll also reflect in the path I'm drawing. So let's try and recreate this paper airplane effect that we see here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to a uniform stroke to start off with, go to Dynamic Sketch again, click, hold down, hold down the Option key to make a straight line and the Shift key to make it horizontal. I'm going to make this uniform stroke with only one point in width. And then I'm going to go to the Width tool in Illustrator. This is the native variable stroke width tool that Illustrator provides. And I'm going to drag out an increased width like that. And it's starting to look like this effect here. Now, because I've got the annual service plan, I'm going to call in the services of the width selector tool. And this is part of the width scribe one. So it's a different plugin, but you've got access to it in the annual service plan as well. So go to the Window menu, width scribe, width selector panel. And I'm going to click on that to select it just like I did with Dynamic Sketch. And I can marquee select a certain width marker like this. And I'm going to make that width marker a bit bigger. And that will create a blunter end on the end of this variable stroke width. I think 5 points is good. I can select the last mark on this, the tail of this stroke, and I can keep it at 1 point, or I can increase it a little bit, but I think it was quite good where it was. And now if I deselect, I can see it's looking much more like the width profile I see here. Perhaps it's a bit thicker, so let me go down to 15 points. And I can make sure in the stroke panel on the right hand side here that I have got the round cap and the round join selected. That ensures that when you're sketching, it looks a little bit more natural at the ends and at the corners of a sketch. So now I have this variable stroke width here selected, and I can see it in the drop-down panel here. I can go back to the dynamic sketch tool, and I can sketch away with that stroke, just like that. If I wanted a straight line, remember, I just click, hold the Option key, and I can draw a straight line like that. So I can recreate this style very, very quickly. If you are wondering where the control for this new functionality is, in the Dynamic Sketch tool, which I'm still in at the moment, I can hit the Enter or Return key, and I can see the Preferences window. The other way to get to this Preferences window is a flyout menu, and opt for Dynamic Sketch Preferences. Or, as with all tools, double-click on the toolbox icon and you get the preferences. And I can see here is the option, which is the new option, which is retain existing variable stroke width. So this is what I've been demonstrating. You can turn it off to return to the previous functionality, but if I tick this, it has a new functionality. Some final things to note. When you're drawing with this method, make sure you have none selected as the stylus pressure input. If you have stylus pressure going, then it's going to first take that stylus pressure from the stylus device. Finally, because you're applying a custom variable stroke width effectively, these strokes are no longer dynamic in the classic sense with Dynamic Sketch, but you can continue to edit them if you like by simply enabling this option here. And if I now draw here in this stroke, you'll see it edits that path as you'd expect. I hope you've enjoyed this update, and if you have any other ideas or suggestions for our plugins, please don't hesitate to contact us. Thank you very much.